Hey guys, and welcome to my channel. Time is but a window. Today we're going to be doing another Overwatch. You can see it's the fifth round. The suspect has 100% headshot percentage, but he only has one kill. But there is something going on here, and even though it might not be cheating, it is still something that looks a little bit suspicious. The suspect's going to be pushing around here towards terrorist spawn, and it looks like two guys are just spinning around in circles. One guy's sitting there with an AWP, and one guy just straight up AFK. So, it looks like this is actually a D-ranking game for the terrorists. I have been seeing more and more of these, especially with the CTs actually moving around. And, because of that, it makes it difficult to report. Because ever since Valve changed it over so that boosting games are supposed to be reported, D-ranking games, however, if they're not on the side of the D-rankers, don't have to be reported. So these CTs are all kind of running in there and getting kills, and while they're going to get some Elo and possibly rank up from this, there is nothing we can really say about it. This can't be reported as a griefing charge. And the suspect's just going to keep making his way over here and taking out the terrorists. We'll let him do it one more time before I finish this off and wrap this up and move on to the next case. But, again, I don't know why he's actually watching over here. Maybe he thinks that the terrorists are actually going to start doing something since one of them is getting kills. Emu's going to take down two, and that's just going to leave one terrorist left. And he's going to finish him off as well. Alright guys, so unless something were to all of a sudden happen and the terrorists were going to come back, there is a good chance that this game is just a D-ranking game for the terrorists. And the CTs, we have no reason to suspect we're doing anything against terms at all. Moving on. Hey guys, and welcome to my channel. Time is but a window, and right now it looks like we're watching a bot play. And, well, honestly guys, we're gonna have to wait until the... Oh, the suspect's back actually, but he seems to be AFK. And that's not all that's going on. As you can see, Mask is hopping around backwards. Looks like he's actually kind of like, using some kind of aim bot while, looking the wrong way. So it's like a spin bot, but it's like an anti-aim. That's what the word is. That's what I'm looking for. Either way, the suspect here is AFK and not doing too much. But since it is office, there's a good chance he's probably cheating. Let's be honest, this is the number one cheat map of all time. And yes, thank you for not disappointing me, suspect. Looks like a couple B-hops right off the bat. Looking over here towards Bulldog, able to tap him down. Looking like a little bit of an aim lock to me. And he's gonna make his way through here. Actually, one guy coming behind, he knows he's there. Aiming on him right through the wall. He's just gonna come out right on him, shoot him in the face, watch it lock onto his head. And he's able to take him down. Alright. So yeah, this is pretty much your typical office experience here, guys. For any newcomers to Counter-Strike Global Offensive, try to stay away from this map. It used to be pretty fun back in the old days, but if you play it in competitive nowadays, this is all you get. Tons of cheaters, spin botters, aim botters, wall hackers. It's just a total shit show. Either way, he's just gonna follow Mask over here. Doesn't even seem to walk. He just sits there crouched looking backwards, and some kind of crazy anti-aim going on there. And the suspect's gonna continue to move over here. B-hop his way over towards CT spawn. One AFK here. He's gonna be able to take him down without an issue. Actually kept running forward, so the bullets were a little bit inaccurate, but he is able to take him down. And it looks like there are still three guys over here. Looked like he just wanted to join in the fun of cheating in this game, I guess, because he did go AFK that amount of time. I assume it's because his teammate was cheating, maybe a few of his teammates cheating, if you look at how many kills Wagon and Mask also have. So yeah, well, at least we're gonna be able to get rid of him. He should get a ban here. It looks like he has a sticker on this gun, and wow, just wow. I mean, I would love to be able to hit shots like that legitimately, because that was just insane how he picked up those three headshots. Either way, he's just gonna make his way back over here towards, looks like, long haul. Spots out one guy, trying to shoot him down. He is able to take him out. Takes out Iceberg and Sheep as well. And that's still going to leave one CT left, all the way back towards the hostage rescue zone. He's able to take down Toucan, only to get traded out by Wagon, who's running around with a scout and headshotting everyone. So there are three cheaters in this game. It's a shame I can't ban them all. But at least I'll be able to ban the suspect, though Valve, it would be great if you guys could implement an Overwatch 2.0 so that I can go in and ban these other two guys that are Wagon and Mask for also cheating. I mean, I don't see why you don't allow us to spectate multiple different players. They're already aliased, so we don't know their actual names. And if we see people cheating, we should just be able to report them. Either way, Overwatch resolution time. Major disruption aim assistance, that's evident beyond reasonable doubt. And then we got major disruption vision assistance, which is also evident beyond reasonable doubt, as well as other external assistance. And he was bunny hopping like crazy. So evident beyond reasonable doubt there. Anyways, guys, I guess you could technically report the griefing for when he was gone for that many rounds and turning on the cheats. Technically, it's a very, very loose area right there. But in all honesty, I'm not going to do that. Not going to waste Valve's time looking for any griefing here. I just want them to get rid of this guy. And they should, because he's got other external assistance, vision assistance, and aim assistance. Anyways, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Let me know what you guys think in the comments down below. And have a great day.